said about you.
Aiden.
Your boyfriend.
Aiden, stop. Okay, I know what I'm doing.
Well, maybe you do, Kendall, but I just think you can do a whole lot better than Michael Cambius.
Well, I certainly hope she doesn't agree with you.
Michael.
Hey, gorgeous.
Hi. I wasn't expecting you to be here.
Well, I figured you needed me here, so I thought I'd come down.
Oh, Aiden, I'll see you later. You want to tell me why you're here?
Well, I could ask you the same question.
Well, Jackson was shot.
Yeah, I heard. It's not good.
Yeah, I'm sure that stone you call a heart is just breaking as we speak.
So you were with Erica when you heard about this?
Yeah, so what?
Well, what exactly were you doing with Erica in the first place? Oh, what a coincidence that you were with Erica when she needed you. Or maybe it was just divine intervention.
I couldn't let her get behind the wheel of a car after getting the news, could I?
You were driving her?
Yes.
So you were on your way to see her after you and I just made that deal, is that right?
You're having a lot of fun trying to make me squirm. You don't see me squirming, do you? So what's your problem?
Oh, I don't have a problem. Though you might.
Michael, we cannot work together unless you trust me.
Trust you? Oh, let's see. The first time that you see Lena, you can't resist the little dig. What was it? Tell Michael that I said hello? You wanted her to know that you knew about us. Why is that?
I felt she had a part of you that belonged to me. I was jealous. Sue me.
Actually, I'd rather hear what you were doing with Erica.
Fine. I had to make sure that Erica didn't suspect Lena was your mole.
And what was your conclusion?
Well, Lena's cover story is working beautifully. Erica thinks that Barton, what's-his-name, really engineered the lawsuit against Fusion.
It's true, isn't it? It was brilliant of my Lena to concoct that little piece of fiction, wasn't it?
On your orders, right?
Mm-hmm.
Does she always do what she's told?
Without question.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So, did you tell her to seduce my sister?
Lena's current assignment is to get Bianca into bed. Trust me, it's not an unpleasant one.
So, Lena is going to seduce Bianca so that she'll go after Boyd's priceless formula?
Mm-hmm. Which, of course, you were supposed to do, but failed.
Well, what makes you think Bianca will do any better?
Because Bianca is Boyd's good friend. And unlike you, she's trustworthy. He won't know what hit him.
Now, do you have any idea how much this will hurt Bianca?
No, please, don't pretend you actually care about her.
It's just, Bianca has had a lot to go through in her life.
Oh, that's true. And poor little thing. Anorexic lesbian with a narcissistic mother. But hey, you know, this is America, so in no time at all, she'll be writing a book and doing all the talk shows. You know, Kendall, if you're going to play me, you should try to make sure that I don't actually see those little wheels of yours spinning in your head.
I'm not trying to play you. It's just that I don't think Bianca deserves to get her heart broken.
Well, who does? Look, Kendall, we have a deal. Do you want enchantment or don't you?
Of course I want enchantment.
Mm-hmm. So you said you wanted to see if Erica suspected Lena of being disloyal. Well, what about you? Didn't she think it was rather strange that you would stop by her office asking all these questions?
Sure, but I told her I was there to tell her she was right. And Erica was only too happy to believe me.
Whoa. Right about what?
You. That you had some ulterior motive in dating me. She'd been saying that since Aspen. So she felt superior, and it was very easy for her to see how much I despise you now.
That's good. Very impressive. Actually, you know, I think I'm gonna believe you because I just sort of like the vision of you standing in front of Erica degrading yourself. and on that. Plus, that if you're lying to me, I'll make you pay.
Oh, screw this. Screw this. I'll have to put up with this abuse, not for 10 enchantments. If I have to justify myself every time I do something, I can take down Erica on my own. I don't need you.
Kendall. Just wait a second. Relax, Kendall. You're doing well. I'm proud of you.
Can't imagine how much that means to me.
Well, listen, just don't get too smart. No more strategic moves without telling me first.
Fine.
Oh, excuse me. I'm looking for Dr. Joe Martin. He's taking care of my uncle, Jackson Montgomery.
Oh, sure. If you just wait right here, I'll track down Dr. Martin for you.
Okay.
Now, is there anything else?
No. I think we understand each other.
Yeah, I think it's going on. Is Jackson all right?
Oh, he's still unconscious. I'm more worried about Mom right now. I don't know how she's going to react if he wakes up and something's wrong.
Something wrong, like what?
Well, like, he lost a lot of blood. And they don't even know how long he was in that alley before he was found, so.
Oh, yeah, God, I'm sorry.
You know what, Kendall, just save it.
Look, I'm only trying to...
What, to comfort me? Why?
What do you mean, why?
Why, because you're my sister? And you love me?
No, you feel bad.
Well, as bad as I feel right now, I imagine that Boyd felt even worse when you were through with him. I mean, you pretended to care about him for your own selfish reasons. What you did was really low, Kendall.
What if I had a really good reason for doing what I did?
Kendall, your reasons don't matter. You took advantage of somebody's feelings for you. That's totally unforgivable.
Did you find Lena?
Yeah, she went out for takeout.
So, is Lena a friend or a girlfriend?
Why do you care?
I care, Bianca. Will you please answer me?
Lena is a girlfriend.
Really? So how long have you been together?
Not long, but what we have is real.
How do you know that?
You know what, Kendall? I really don't want to talk about this with you.
Why not?
Why do I always have to justify my feelings? I mean, when you're involved in a new relationship with a man, does everybody automatically assume that it's not going to work out? That it'll just burn itself out, or better yet, that whoever he is, he's just going through a phase. And once he snaps out of it, he'll realize...
No, I'm not thinking that, okay? I don't want you to be alone. No matter how we feel about each other, I think you're a good person, and you deserve to be with someone.
What is this?
Can we go somewhere more private? I have something I have to tell you.